Hello, hello out there. This is the Master Communicator, Sharon C. Jenkins, and you are listening to Author Central Station. And we are on Afro Vibes Radio worldwide. We are actually in 178 countries. So if you want to be internationally known and you want your book to be read internationally, you need to come on Author Central Station, because guess what? We expose you to the world. Today, I am thrilled beyond thrilled to have Kevin D. Wardrow, Boudreau, on the show. And I am so excited. And the beauty of everything is the fact that he is telling his story in his book. He is a master authorpreneur. He is an entrepreneur, and he has a story to tell.
Yes.
Now, we had to bring him in to make this special announcement that he has a book coming. Ooh. And hopefully, if everything goes well, we will have that book available to you in July.
That's it.
July of this year.
Yes.
So get ready. So let me tell you a little bit about Kevin. His book is titled Becoming, My Journey from Boyhood to Manhood. He started his business in 2013, and he is the owner of Be The Man Men's Apparel and Accessories. As you can see, he is dressed and styled, and he is looking all right. Right, Mama Darla?
Right.
He is looking good. Go on now,
yes,
Kevin.
Yes, thank you.
He was born in Houston, Texas. In the Fifth Ward, am I correct?
Fifth Ward, Texas. The great community of Fifth Ward.
And he is the sixth child,
yes,
of nine kids,
yes,
to Evelyn and Lawrence Boudreau.
Yes.
Woo! And guess what? He is madly in love, married forever and ever to Miss Darla.
Yes.
Woo! Woo!
Yes,
beautiful
Darla.
Inside and out.
Yes, she is.
And they have three beautiful girls.
Yes.
So I'll save my secret that I'm going to share about Mr. Kevin,
okay,
to the end.
Okay.
But I'm curious.
Yes, ma'am.
Why in the world did you decide to write a book about manhood?
Because number one, it's needed. I think that a lot of people, especially men, you know, you don't really find a lot of books on men. You know, especially transparent books like mine. So, you know, it's very needed, and it can cover a long, wide age range from the teenage male,
mm-hmm,
to the beginning male, 18 and up, to the older male. My,
mm-hmm,
book is for everyone.
Wow.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow. Yeah, because manhood,
yes,
is,
yes,
something,
yes,
that you have to grapple with.
Yes.
From,
yes,
birth
is,
until death.
That's it. That's it.
From
and
birth.
Until
death.
And that's why my book is called Becoming and not Become, because it's an everlasting, continuous move. You know, I haven't become yet. I'm becoming.
Wow.
And I probably won't become until I'm dead and gone. But as long as I'm here, I'm always becoming.
Ooh, that from glory to glory,
glory
that's going
glory.
On.
Yes, ma'am.
I hear you.
Yes,
that perfecting.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, being,
yes,
perfected.
That's it.
Oh, I love it.
That's
I love it.
It. Yes, ma'am.
So, I happen to have seen a copy of your cover.
Yes, yes, yes.
And it is dynamite. We went back to that, to the 50s and the 60s, where,
mm-hmm,
we were talking about good times.
Yes.
And we're talking,
yes,
about, what's his name? JJ.
Dynamite.
It is dynamite. Now tell us a little bit about why you chose this particular, what's on the cover, number,
okay,
one.
Okay.
And number two, why you chose that design.
You stated earlier my business is men fashion, you know, so I wanted to kind of put that in there with the shoes along with the arrow of journey going forward, because, you know, it is a journey. So I wanted people to get the real aspect of what my book entails before they even, you know, a lot of times you can look at the cover of a book and you can kind of tell, you know, what the book is going to be about. So that's what I was trying to do, get the people to understand that this is a journey that I am on. So that's the aspect that I wanted to make sure they were going to be.
So the beauty of that is you allow men to not have to show up completely fashioned and what they think is successful, but you give them permission to be formed, to be shaped, be molded, to be pressed. And sometimes you gotta trim some stuff, prune some stuff down. So tell us a little bit about the pruning process in your life.
Oh man, people don't like the pruning. The pruning doesn't feel good. But if you would understand that the pruning is necessary, you know, you think of a plant. Sometimes you have, or your garden. Sometimes you have to get in your garden and you have to prune out some things, only to prune those things out so that your garden or your roses or your flowers can actually grow even better. And that's the same thing with manhood. Sometimes as men, we have to be pruned, not to hurt us or not to cancel us out, but so that we can grow even stronger and become better than the man that we already are.
That's a wonderful thing. Yeah. And I think one of the things that we wrestle with, unfortunately, today, we are in Houston, Texas, we just witnessed a school shooting.
Yes.
And in my mind, I keep asking the question, what if that boy knew who he really was? He would not have been able to devalue life enough to take it in the numbers, to take it period, because he alone would know that he has a purpose.
That's right.
Let's talk about when you discovered that you had a purpose.
It took, I'm going to tell you, Ms. Sharon, it took a while. I bumped my head many, 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 many times. You know, I didn't have, number one, I didn't have a relationship with God. I think that that has to be your foundation for everything. You have to make God the head of your life. And once I accepted Christ into my life, everything else kind of just started to fall into place. But I realized and understand that the foundation of everything was my relationship with Christ. You know, going back to the young man from the shooting earlier today in Santa Fe, it's amazing to me how we think of all these school shootings, and none of them are female. All of them are, majority of them are male. And you ask yourself the question, what if that person really knew who they were? What if that person had the proper guidance that he needed? You know, the enemy hates males for some reason, always has and always will. And we have to realize and understand that he can't stand us. So we have to make sure that we walk in our full manhood.
Well, part of that is because you are seed bearers.
Yes.
And whenever you bear seed, that means that you have the opportunity to change a nation.
Yes.
So, you know, it, as a seed bearer, not only can you change a nation, but you can change a world.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Because I remember the story about this virgin girl and how she was impregnated.
Yes.
And then this dude, he showed up.
Come on, come on, come on.
And the next thing you know, the world was changed.
Oh, just like that. All from a seed.
Yes, all from a seed. So that, to me, it makes sense that if you annihilate the seed bearer, then the righteous seed can't be born and can influence and populate the earth. And populate the earth. So, yeah, that makes sense to me, brother.
Yes, ma'am, it makes sense to me, too.
Okay, so obviously you've had success.
Yes, I have.
Okay. So what was it like in your transition from who you were to who you were becoming?
Oh, man. A lot of sleepless and crying nights. You know, I had to really just kind of look at myself in the mirror. You know, Michael Jackson has a song, "The Man in the Mirror." You know, I realized that I couldn't look around. I couldn't make excuses anymore. I couldn't blame, you know, the color of my skin or how I was raised as a child, or my neighborhood. You know, I had to look at myself and take ownership of you know, who I was. And again, it goes back to that foundation, which is the Lord. You know, hey, he called me a priest. He called me a king. He called me, you know what I'm saying? I am the head and not the tail. I am the lender and not the borrower. I am above and not beneath. And when I begin to tell myself that and get in the mirror and really point to myself and let myself know that, hey, I'm becoming the man that God has called me to be. I have purpose, you know what I'm saying? I have a destiny. I have a call on my life. So, you know, that, and then I begin to surround myself with the right type of people that can uplift me, you know what I'm saying, to get to that plateau level instead of people that was bringing me down or that can bring me down, like the people that I was hanging with before.
So let's talk about your mission to suit men.
Yes.
In clothing
yes.
that speaks about their purpose.
Yes.
So what made you decide to do that, deal with men's clothing and accessories as an entrepreneur?
Miss Sharon, when I tell you that God is so strategic, you know, I'll never ever forget the day that my business was actually birthed. We were sitting at a restaurant in Luby's Cafeteria on a Sunday afternoon. We had just came out of church service. And I'm sitting across from my pastor, and you know, I'm sitting there eating my food, and she's eating her food, and she drops her fork, and you know, I'm like, okay, what is going on? And she asked me a question, you know, what do I feel, how do I feel about me and ties and me and accessory? And you know, I was like, I love it, you know, I mean, because even before I started dressing the way that I was dressing, I always had an eye for fashion. Mm-hmm. You know, I would walk in men's stores, K&G, and I'll just put suits together. Didn't have a dime in my pocket, but I would put suits together and just walk out, you know, and I'll come back, and people will be at the register buying. Like, I like the way you put that together. I was like, it just happened. But I told her, I said, I just like it. And she said, you know, and then she began to speak into my life, and right then and there, my business was birthed, you know, and she said, the Lord is telling me to tell you, you have 7 days to get your DBA.
Ooh.
Yeah. Now, this was a Sunday.
Ooh.
She said, the Lord is saying you have 7 days to get your DBA. Mm. Now, I work Monday through Friday. Mm-hmm. I work evening shift. You know, I work Monday through Thursday, sorry. I'm only off on Friday. So I knew that Monday through Thursday, I wouldn't be able to get my DBA. Mm-hmm. So my only day to get it was Friday. And I want to tell you, Ms. Sharon, to make a long story short, that I walked in the DBA's office. They close at 4. Mm. I walked in the DBA's office at 3:50 to get my DBA.
Mm.
But I wanted to show God that I was serious about what it is that he wanted to do in my life.
Mm.
You know, and people, I think that, especially men, don't think that fashion is important.
Mm-hmm.
But it really is, you know, because it speaks before you even walk in the room. How you're dressed says who you are before you even walk in.
So one of the things that I love about what you do is you let the internal work that was happening on the inside of you be magnified on the external, and then you took it the next step and you started helping people to live their purpose on the outside.
Yes.
That is so powerful.
I love it.
Yes, that is powerful.
And I realized, you know, that I wanted to make sure that people had, or me in particular, had the support that maybe I didn't have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because a lot of times men walk around and they think that no one sees them.
Mm-hmm.
They think that there is no one there to help them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, I want to be that help.
Amen.
I want to make sure that they live their life on purpose, that they walk in the purpose that God has given them. And like you said, starting internally, and then we'll work externally.
Yeah. And that book talks about that internal work.
Yes.
So one of the things that I want to say before we go to break is I really appreciate you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so very much.
And I appreciate you listening, audience. And so we're going to take a few minute break.
Yes.
You are listening to Author Central Station on AfroVibes Radio Worldwide. And we'll be back in a few. Hello, you are back, and we are back. This is Author Central Station, Sharon C. Jenkins, the Master Communicator. And we are worldwide on Afro Vibes Radio. You want to make sure you check us out. You know what? Not only check us out, check out our blog, check out everything about us. We have some dynamic shows, and you don't want to miss a one of them. Now, on Author Central Station, we have the distinct pleasure of interviewing authors. Sometimes they're about to launch a book, and then sometimes they're seasoned authors. But today we have a newbie, sitting in the chair beside me. His name is Kevin D. Bordeaux. I don't know, you know, I don't have that New Orleans accent. So if I don't quite get it right, it's not because my intent is anything but excellence.
Come on.
So hey, Kevin!
Hello.
Boudreaux!
Yes, ma'am. Woo-hoo!
You doing good?
I'm doing great.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about what this book is going to mean to your family.
Okay. I think that I have, right now, me and my family, we're actually focusing on the generation that's coming behind us. And fortunately for us, the generation that's coming behind us are majority males.
Oh.
So I have more nephews than I do nieces.
Wow.
So I think that this book will actually inspire and touch and motivate them even more so, because again, we always out trying to help the next generation, you know, because it's not about us, it's about those that's coming behind us,
right?
You know, so and fortunately for me, those that's coming behind me in my family are majority males.
Oh wow.
You know, I didn't have any sons, but I have three beautiful daughters, you know, who I do believe that can still, you know, benefit from the book. But even more so, my nephews, or either like any young man that I'm attached to or I'm connected with, can actually benefit from it.
So I'm going to get ready to ask you a deep question. You ready, Kevin?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the difference between malehood and manhood?
Okay, now this is just my personal perspective on the matter.
And you are an expert, so we value your opinion.
Well, thank you. But you're doing exactly what it is that you're supposed to be doing. You know, manhood is not easy, but manhood is very necessary.
I hear you.
Yes,
I hear you. So, what is the hypocritical version of a man who embraces manhood? What's that hypocritical version? I'm curious. What's the opposite? I guess I need to bring clarity to the question. What's the opposite of manhood, of being a man?
Right. And basically, like you said, the hypocritical, I like that word, the hypocritical. And basically what that is someone that's doing the talk but not doing the walk. Mm-hmm. You know, someone that's walking around with their chest out saying, I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. But when you look around their life, you know, it's not lining up with what they're saying. You know, I see you're saying you're a man, but everything around me is showing boyhood or malehood. So there is a difference.
Wow. So another thing I'm curious about is in your journey to becoming a man, what are some of the benefits that you have reaped as a result of you saying yes to becoming a man?
The number one thing is I would say is my marriage, my wife. You know, I think that no husband, you know, a good husband can be a husband and not be a man. You know, so that's the most important thing is my marriage, with my wife.
So how do you protect, secure, and love her like a man should?
You have to follow the biblical principles. That's the only way. You have to follow the biblical principles. You have to treat her just like Christ did the church. Doesn't make you perfect, doesn't say that you're not going to make mistakes, doesn't say that you're not going to make errors, but you just have to be continuous with it. Yes.
Excuse me. So, what's your power source? You're a Superman.
Yes.
What is your power source?
Prayer.
Whoa.
Prayer.
You mean men pray?
Prayer. Men pray. As a matter of fact, men, that should be one of the first things that men do, is pray. You know, pray. It's prayer. It's all prayer. Whether I'm up, whether I'm down, whether I'm good, whether I'm not good, it's always prayer.
Wow.
It's prayer.
Wow. Wow. I love it. Mm-hmm. I love it. Mm-hmm. So, I've got another couple of questions for you.
Yes, ma'am.
First time author.
Yes. Yes.
What's it like to be a first time author?
Oh, it's rewarding. It's exciting. A little nervous, you know. Don't really know exactly what it is to expect, because this is a new road for you. This is a new journey. You never traveled down this road before. So, you know, it's exciting and a little nervousness all at the same time.
Wow, wow. So what helped you to find the courage to write this book? Because, you know, people, even on reality shows,
Yes. They
craft the story.
Yes.
You see an element of the truth, but
Right. Not
the whole truth sometimes.
Exactly.
So what gave you the courage to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth?
Honestly, again, it goes back to my spiritual covering, goes back to my life coach. I didn't really feel as though, I love to talk, but I didn't really feel as though I had anything to say that people would want to hear. But she challenged me one day, like a true life coach does, you know, to get the writing. And I did it. And it was a struggle at first, but the more I wrote, the more I started to realize, hey, this gonna help someone. Because the crazy part about it is, even as I was writing, and I'm the author, it was helping me, Steve.
So, I love it. Mm-hmm. I love it. So, who is your target audience? I'm asking you this question specifically because I think people are going to be surprised by your answer.
Yes, yes. Number one, it's a wide range, but single moms who have teenage boys or who have young boys, and maybe the young man is not going the way that you would hope for him to go. And I know that there were times that I wasn't going the way that my mom wanted me to go, but thanks be unto God, you know. So single moms or moms who are trying to raise young men in a single parent home, or maybe the father is not in their life, you know, I want them to read my book, and after they read my book, say, you know what, this young man made it. My son is going to make it too.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
I love it.
Yes, ma'am.
So, in the total scheme of things, mm-hmm. I'm curious, what's next for author Kevin D. Boudreaux?
Well, you know, I realized from writing my first book that I kind of liked writing. I really did. I kind of liked writing, you know. It really gave me a sense of liberty, a sense of freedom. And, you know, I'm always about empowering and influencing people. So, as we speak now, I'm writing my second book.
Wow.
Yes,
see,
ma'am.
The secret is out the
yes,
bag
ma'am.
Now.
Yes, yes.
The secret.
Yes.
And the name is The Six.
Yes.
What now?
The Six C's to Success.
Woo!
Sweet. Yes.
Oh, that
there
is
six of
awesome.
Them. Six C's to
six
Success.
Six of them.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm not going to ask for a sneak preview. Or can I?
Well, I mean, what I can do is give you one of the C's.
Yeah, I'll take
okay,
that.
Okay, can we do that?
Yeah, I'll
and
take
I'll
that.
And I'll start with the first one.
Okay.
The first one is Be Called.
Ooh.
You got to make sure that what it is that you're doing, what it is that you're trying to succeed in, that God has actually called you in. And
wow.
Makes, yeah.
Wow.
That's all I'm going to say. I'm just going to leave it.
That you're retrofitted.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
For the call.
Yes.
Body, mind, and spirit.
And spirit. That's
ooh,
it.
Ooh, right.
That's it.
Right.
And you're not just kind of just doing something happy stance.
Yeah, or
you say,
mimicking somebody else.
That's it. But you're called to this.
Oh, wow.
And because I'm called to it, I'm going to be a success in it.
So are you a speaker also?
You know what? I have spoken before a couple of times, you know. I have. I love to speak. I've always loved to talk. I always love to talk and inspire and empower people and just make people believe that they can do whatever it is that they're trying to do.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Yes, ma'am. So you're inspirational, you're authentic, and you love your wife.
I do.
What is the benefit of loving your wife? Can you tell her? Give them a list, a laundry list. Because there's some folks out there that like, Monday, I'm going to be at the courthouse?
Yeah.
Monday. Yeah. Tell them what they're doing wrong, brother.
You don't. Hey, listen. Don't. Marriage is not easy, of course. It's a fight. It really is. It's a fight. But God will make sure that you will have the victory in the fight if you are fighting. Mm. You know, a lot of times in marriages, there is a fight, but it's only one person fighting. I think that what helps me and my wife is it's not just me fighting, or it's not just her fighting, but we're both fighting. And I think it's a lot easier when both people are fighting instead of one.
Wow,
yes,
wow, I tell you. Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so you heard it from Kevin. Kevin told you, you got to work. And you know, when the honeymoon is over, that's when the work begins.
Yes.
Yes, yes, yes,
yes.
So, be coming.
Yes, ma'am.
July 2018.
Yes. Get ready.
Get ready.
Get ready.
We're going to throw a party.
We're going to throw a party. We're going to have a
good
time.
Ooh, I love it. I love it. I love
yes,
it.
I'm excited. I'm
so, do you excited. Have a website, Facebook page, Instagram page, anything
yes.
where people can find out about who you are and what you do?
Right now, my website is actually under construction. We're making some changes to it and make it benefit, you know, the book that's getting ready to come out. But I am on Facebook and I am on Instagram. You can find me on Facebook at Kevin D. Boudreaux. And you can find me on Instagram at Be The Man. That's B, not B-E, just the letter B, T-H-E-M-A-N, the number 6. Be The Man 6.
So, let's say our audience was nothing but menfolk out there.
Mm-hmm.
What is the message that you would leave them with, Kevin?
It's not about how you start. It's all about how you finish. Someone told me a long time ago, you don't need finishing grace until you get started. You know, men, I know that there's some men out there that have businesses brewing in their spirit. They have things that they want to do. All you have to do is get started, and God will make sure that you finish.
Wow, I love it. I love it. Now, let's talk to the single mothers out there who have sons.
Yes.
Because I am a single mother, and
yes,
I had two sons.
Mm.
And boy, sometimes I wanted to know, what should I do? The baby came home, the police knocked on the door.
Oh.
And I opened the door. I didn't even know the boy had slipped out of the window. The police said, let me tell you, Kevin, the police said he was running with a friend behind a grocery store and had a bandana of a certain color hanging out of his pocket. I didn't even know the boy knew what a gang was. So can you talk to the single mamas out there? The policeman was cute, by the way.
First thing I want to encourage single moms is you don't have to try to raise your son to be a man. You know, a lot of times moms feel as though that they have to train their or help their son be a man because, you know, their father is not in their life. You don't have to do that. All you can do is nurture your son. All you can do is show him love. You know, sometimes it may be tough love, but show him love, show him patience. And just let, a lot of times, young men just want to know that you're paying attention to them, that they're just not out here. I know that, you know, I don't have my dad or you're a single mom, but, you know, just don't let me get caught up in your, like, not forget about me in your everyday life. I just need some, not all of your attention, I just need some of your attention to let me know that, you know, you see me.
Wow,
yeah.
That is so powerful. Mm-hmm. Now, one last thing.
Yes, ma'am.
One last thing I need to know.
Yes, ma'am.
From a male perspective,
yes, ma'am.
What would you say to single women out there who are looking for their Boaz or Mr. Right or whatever they calling them nowadays? What would you say?
I would tell them to take their attention off looking for their Boaz. Because the Bible says, he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtaineth favor. He don't realize that he has to find you, because connected to you is his favor. So stop looking and allow the man to find you.
That was worth a million,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes, yes.
So again, how can our listening audience contact you?
Okay, yeah, again, Facebook, Kevin D. Boudreaux. Instagram, BeTheMan6. Email address, BeTheMan6@yahoo.com. That's it, yeah.
Oh,
again,
I love it.
My website is under construction now. We're working on getting ready.
For the launch.
Yes, ma'am.
For that launch.
Yes, ma'am.
Y'all, when y'all see Kevin's cover, your mind is
yes.
going to be blown.
Yes.
B-L-O-W-N.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Kevin,
Thank
for
you.
Being on
Thank
our show
so
today.
Much for me.
Oh, you
Thank
are so,
you so
welcome.
Much,
you are so welcome. Well, listening audience, I just want to say thank you so much for tuning in. This is a bright day in the neighborhood. Monday is here. So what I want to say to you is get your tube right, because you got to run for the rest of the week. And I want you to win. W-I-N. I want you to win. And last but not least, I am going to be with Dr. Connie Stewart at the Winner's Circle, or in the Winner's Circle, for her greater conference, Greatness is Calling You, on May the 26th at 10 a.m. And it's going to be at Hilton Houston West Chase. And guess what? You want to be there at 10 a.m. You can go to bloomfestconference.com. And register.
Yes.
We hope to see you there. You're going to see Kevin there. You're going to see
there.
Me there.
I will be there.
You're going to see, you're going to get your greatness on.
Yes.
And we all have the potential to be great.
That's right.
Thank you for tuning in. Next week, I am going to have a matchmaker author in the house.
All right.
So ladies and men who are looking for that mate, Kevin just told us, don't look.
Don't even look.
But you're peeping.
You can
peep a little bit.
There you go.
Yeah, if you peeping, you want to tune in. She writes excellent books. And I just want to say, appreciate you and have a great week. I love you, and there ain't nothing you can do about it. Bye-bye.